Don't touch me.
This is a rowdy group here.
Shinkai.
hardly see. She's almost blind.
Tell the truth, Abram. Is your son so much to look at? The way he looks, the way she sees, it's a perfect match.
Renafum, the beggar. Here now is one copper.
One kopeck. Last week you gave me two kopecks.
I had a bad week.
So if you had a bad week, why should I suffer?
And most important, our beloved rabbi.
Rabbi, may I ask you a question?
Certainly, my son.
Is there a proper blessing to pull this off?
A blessing for the Tzar, of course. May God bless and keep the Tzar. Away from us.
Then there are the others in our village. They make a much bigger circle. His Honor the Constable. His Honor the Priest. His Honor many, many others. We don't bother them so far, they don't bother us. And among ourselves, we always get along perfectly well. Of course, there was the time when he stole him a horse and he delivered a mule, but that's all over. Now we live in simple peace and harmony. It was a mule.
It was a horse.
Inside. Golda! Golda!
see you. I have such news for you. Not just every day of the week news. Once in a lifetime news. Where are your children? Outside? Good, good, good. Ah, yes. Such diamonds, such jewels. You'll see, Gold. I'll find husbands for every one of them. But you shouldn't be so picky. The worst husband, God forbid, is better than no husband, God forbid. And who should know better than I? Ever since my Aaron died, I've been a poor widow, all alone. No one to talk to, nothing to say to anyone. There's no life. Why, at night, all I do is think about him. And even thinking about him gives me no pleasure, because you know as well as I, he was not much of a person. Everything he touched turned to mud. Not much better than nothing.
Good evening. Is Mrs. Seidel in the house?
She's busy. Come back later.
There's something I'd like to tell her.
Later. Well, I thought I heard.
Finish what you were doing. I said later.
Right.
What does that poor little tailor want with Seidel?
Well, they have been friends since they were babies together. They talk and they play.
They play? What do they play?
Who knows? They're just children.
From such children come other children. Oh, children, children. They're your blessing in your old age. My Aaron couldn't give me children. Believe me, he was as good as gold. Never raised his voice to me. But other than that, he was not much of a man. So, what good is it if he never raised his voice? But what's the use of complaining? Other women are more than not Yenta. Not every woman in the world is a Yenta. Well, Golda, I must go prepare my poor salad table. It was a pleasure talking our hearts out to one another.
Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Oh, my head. One day it'll fall off altogether. A horse will kick it into the mud. Goodbye, Yenta. Of course, the news. It's about Laser Wolf, the butcher. A good man, a fine man. And I don't have to tell you he's well off. But he's lonely, the poor man. You understand, of course you do. In short, out of all the village, he's cast his eye on Zaito.
My Zaito?
No, the Zard Zaito. Of course your Zaito.
Oh, such a match for my Zaito. But Tevia wants a learned man. He doesn't like Lazar.
Listen to me, Golda. Send Tevia to him. Don't tell him what it's about. Let Lazar discuss it himself. He's a good man. He's a wealthy man. True, true. So, you'll tell me how it goes? And you don't have to thank me, Golda. Because aside from my fee, which otherwise Lazar will pay, it brings me such happiness to help other people. What other happiness is there? Goodbye, Golda. You're welcome.
What did you want, Mama?
When I want you to know, I'll tell you. Finish what you were doing.
I wonder if Yenta found a match for you, Zaito.
I'm not interested in Yenta finding me a husband.
Not unless it's Motto, the tailor.
I didn't ask you.
Zaito, you're the oldest. They have to make a match for you before they can make one for me.
And then after her, one for me. So if Yenta brings...
Oh, Yenta, Yenta, Yenta.
Well, somebody has to arrange matches. Young people can't decide these things for themselves.
She might bring someone wonderful, someone interesting,
and well off,
and important.
Matchmaker, matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a fly to hatch me a catch. Matchmaker, matchmaker, look through your book and make me a perfect match. Matchmaker, matchmaker, I'll bring the veil. You bring the groom, slender and frail. Bring me a ring, for I'm longing to be the enviable. For all the men, I can't escape.
right? Of course, right. Cheryl O'Hara.
Have I a match for you? He's handsome, he's young. All right, he's 62, but he's a nice man.
That's true?
True. I promise you'll be happy, and even if you're not, there's more to life than that. Don't ask me what.
I'd build a big tall house with
with rooms by the dozen, right in the middle of the town. A fine tin roof with real wooden floors below. There would be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer coming down. And one more leading nowhere, just for show. I fill my yard with chicks and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear, squawking just as noisily as they can. And each little quack and a hawk and a boom and a boom will land like a trumpet on the air, as if to say, here lives a wealthy man. If I were a rich man, yeah-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee
if I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. And a little, if I were a bitty, bitty rich, diddle, 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 diddle man, I'd see my wife, my golden, looking like a rich man's wife, with a proper double chin, supervising meals to her heart's delight. I'd see her putting on airs and strutting like a peacock. Oh, what a happy mood she's in, screaming at her servants day and night. The most important men in town would come to fawn on me. They would ask me to advise them, just like a Solomon the Wise. If you please, Rebetevye, pardon me, Rebetevye, posing problems out across the rabbi's eyes. If I answer right or wrong, it's when you're rich, they think you really know. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in the synagogue and pray. Maybe have a seat by the eastern wall. I discuss the holy book with the learned men 7 hours a day. That would be the sweetest thing of all. If I were a rich man, yeah. I were a wealthy man.
There he is. You forgot my order for the Sabbath.
But I'm okay. I had a little accident with my horse.
Tevye, you did bring the rabbi's order.
I know, Rev Mendel.
This is bigger news than the plague in Odessa.
Talking about news, terrible news in the outside world, terrible.
What is it? What did it say?
In a town called Brzezinka, all the Jews were evicted, forced to leave their homes.
For what reason?
It doesn't say. Maybe the Tsar wanted their land, maybe a plague.
May the Tsar have his own personal plague.
Amen.
Why
she would bring us some good news.
I only read it was an edict from the authorities.
May the authorities start itching in places they cannot reach.
Amen. Why do you curse them? What good does your cursing do? You stand around and curse and chatter and don't do anything. You'll all chatter your way to the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
And where are you from?
Kiev. I was a student at the university there.
Ah, the university. Is that where you learn to criticize your elders?
That's where I learned that there's more to life than talk. You should know what's going on in the outside world.
Why should I break my head about the outside world? Let them break their own heads.
He's right. As the good book says, when you spit in the air, it lands in your face.
That's nonsense. Oh, you can't close your eyes to what's happening in the world.
He's right.
He's right, and he's right. How can they both be right?
You know, you're also right.
He's right. He's still wet behind the ears. Good Sabbath, W.
Good Sabbath.
Good Sabbath.
Tevye, the rabbi's order. My cheese?
Of course. So, you're from Kiev, right?
Perchik.
Perchik. So you're a newcomer here. As Abraham said, I am a stranger in a strange land.
Moses said that.
No, forgive me. As King David put it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses.
For a man with a slow tongue, he talked a lot.
And the cheese?
Here, have a piece.
Oh, I have no money and I'm not a beggar.
Here, it is a blessing for me to give.
Very well, for your sake.
Thank you. You know, it's no crime to be poor.
In this world, it's the rich who are the criminals. Someday their wealth will be ours.
That would be nice. If they would agree, I would agree.
And who will make this miracle come to pass?
People. Ordinary people.
Like you?
Like me.
Nonsense.
Until your golden day comes, Patrick, how will you live?
By giving lessons to children. Do you have children?
I have 5 daughters.
5?
Daughters.
Girls should learn too. Girls are people.
Oh, radical!
I would be willing to teach them, open their minds to great thoughts.
What great thoughts?
Well, the Bible has many lessons for our times.
Yeah, I'm a very poor man. Food for lessons? Good. Stay the Sabbath with us. Of course, we don't eat like kings, but we don't starve either. And as the good book says, when the poor man eats a chicken, one of them is sick. All right, so it doesn't exactly say that, but someplace it does something about the chicken.
Washed.
The tongue she gets from her mother.
Mother, you're also staying with could get washed.
Tomorrow can help me.
Papa, you listen.
You can wash outside of the well.
Tevye, I have something to say to you.
Why should the day be different?
I have to tell.
Shh, I'm playing.
Laser Wolf wants to see you.
The butcher? About what?
I don't know, only that he says it's important.
What can be important? I had nothing for him to slaughter.
After the Sabbath, see him and talk to him.
Talk about what? If he's thinking about buying my new milk cow, he can forget.
Don't be an ox. A man sends an important message. At least you could do it, talk to him.
Talk about what? He wants my new milk
cow. Talk to him!
All right, after the Sabbath, I'll talk to him.
If they agree on someone, there will be a match, and then it will be too late for us.
I know, don't worry. I found someone who will sell me his used sewing machine. So in a few weeks, I'll save up enough to buy it. And then your father will be impressed with me.
With Mottl, a few weeks may be too late.
What else can we do?
You could ask my father for my hand tonight. Now!
Why should he consider me now? I'm only a poor tailor.
And I'm only the daughter of a poor milkman. Just talk to him.
If your father says no, that's it. It's final. He'll yell at me.
Mottl!
I'm just a poor tailor.
Mottl, even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness.
That's true.
Will you talk to him? Will you talk to him?
I'll talk to him.
It's late. Where is everybody? Late.
Tevye?
Come, children.
Tevye?
Yes, what is it, Mottl?
Tevye.
Well, Mottl, what is it?
Good Sabbath, Tevye.
Good Sabbath.
Deserving of praise.
vodka.
Yes, Laser Wolf.
A bottle of your best brandy and two glasses.
Your best brandy, Red Laser?
What's the occasion? Are you getting ready for a party?
Well, there might be a party. Maybe even the wedding.
A wedding? Wonderful! And I'll be happy to make the wedding merry and lead the dancing and so forth. For a little fee, naturally.
Naturally. A wedding would not be a wedding without you. And your fee.
thank you.
Good evening, innkeeper.
Good evening.
We'd like a drink. Vodka, sir.
Vodka? Schnapps?
Vodka.
Right away.
Good evening.
Good evening, Tevye.
What are you doing here so early, Red Tevye?
He wants to buy my new milk cow. Good evening, Red Laser.
Tevye, sit down. Have a drink.
I won't insult you by saying no.
So how goes it with you, Tevye?
How should it go?
Ah, you're right.
And you?
All the same.
Sorry to hear that.
So how's your brother-in-law in America?
I believe he's doing very well.
Ah, so he wrote you?
Not lately.
Well, how do you know?
If he was doing badly, he would write. May I?
Sure. Tevye, I suppose you know why I wanted to see you.
Yes, I do, Red Laser. But there's no use talking about it.
Why not?
Why, yes. Why should I get rid of her?
You have a few more without her.
I see. So today you want one, tomorrow you may want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
The same as you do with one.
This is very important to me.
Why is it so important to you?
Well, frankly, Tevye, I'm lonesome.
So what are you talking about?
Well, you don't know.
We're talking about my new milk cow, the one you want to buy from me.
Your new milk cow. So I won't be lonesome.
What's so funny?
Well, I'm talking about your daughter. Your daughter Zeitel.
My daughter Zeitel?
Well, of course your daughter Zeitel. I see her in my butcher shop every Thursday. She's made quite a good impression on me. I like her. And as for me, Tevye, you know, I'm quite well off. I've got my own house, a good shop, a servant. But why should we try to impress each other? Let's just shake hands and call it the match. And you won't have to provide a dowry for her. And you might find a little something in your own purse, too.
What do you mean, my purse? Shame on you. My daughter's not the sort I would sell for money.
All right. We won't talk about money. Let's just call it a deal. The main thing is, I like her. I'll make her happy. What do you think?
What do I think? What do I think? I never liked him. Why should I? You can have a fine conversation with him if you talk about kidneys and livers. On the other hand, not everyone has to be a scholar. If you're wealthy enough, no one will call you stupid. With a butcher, my daughter would surely never know hunger. Of course, he has a problem. He's much older than her. That's her problem. But she's much younger. That's his problem. I always thought of him as a butcher, but I misjudged him. He's a good man. He likes her. He'll try to make her happy. What do I think? I think it's a match.
Oh, you agree?
I agree.
Oh, that's wonderful, Tevye. Let's drink on it.
Why not? To you.
No, my friend. To you.
To the both of us.
To our agreement.
To our agreement. To prosperity.
Oh, yeah.
To good health and happiness. And most important, to life, like I am, to life. Father, I've tried to be, it's too my pride to be. Think like I am, to life, like I am, to life. Life has a way of confusing us, messing and bruising us. Think like I am, to life. God would like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lie panting on the floor. How much more can we be joyful when there's really something to be joyful for? Life, like I am. To title my daughter,
my wife.
It gives you something to think about,
something to drink about.
Drink like I am, to life.
Alan, what's that?
Yes, Laser Wolf.
Drinks for everyone.
What's the occasion?
I'm taking myself a drive. Damn you, Zeus. Title.
Thank you.
to the wedding. We will be related. You will be my papa.
Your papa? I always wanted a son, but I wanted one a little younger than myself.
Good evening, Constable. What's the celebration?
Octavius marrying off his eldest daughter.
May I offer my congratulations?
Thank you, yeah.
Oh, Octavio. There's some news I think I'd like to tell you as a friend.
Yes, Yana?
I'm giving you this news because I like you. You're a decent, honest, working person. Even if you are a Jewish dog.
Oh, thank you, Yana. How often does a man get a compliment like that? And your news?
We just received orders that sometime soon this district is to have a little artificial demonstration.
A pogrom? Here?
No, just a little unofficial demonstration.
How little?
Nothing too serious. Just a little mischief, so that if an inspector comes through, he can see that we've done our duty. And personally, I don't see why there needs to be this trouble between people, but I thought I could tell you, and you can tell the others.
Thank you, Your Honor. You're a decent man. If I may say so, it's too bad you're not a Jew.
That's what I like about you, Tabby. You're always joking. And congratulations again for your daughter.
Thank you, Your Honor. Dear Lord, did you have to give me news like that? Today of all days? I know we are the chosen people, but every once in a while, can't you choose someone else? Anyway, thank you for sending a husband for my title. L'chaim.
Children, I will tell you the story from the Bible of Laban and Jacob, and then we will discuss it together, all right? Good. Now, Laban had two daughters, Leah and the beautiful Rachel. And Jacob loved the younger Rachel and asked Laban for her hand. Laban agreed if Jacob would work for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
He was an employer. Now, after he worked for him for 7 years, do you know what happened? Laban fooled him and gave him his ugly daughter, Leah. So to marry Rachel, Jacob was forced to work another 7 years. You see, children, the Bible clearly teaches us you must never trust an employer. Do you understand?
Yes,
Bridget.
Papa isn't done yet?
No, Mama.
Then enough money. We have to do Papa's work today. How long can he sleep? He staggered home last night, fell into bed like a dead man. I couldn't get a word out of him. Put that away and clean the barn. Tell me when Papa gets up.
That is a very interesting lesson, Bridget.
Do you think so?
Although I don't know if Rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
And neither, I suppose, would Rabbi's son.
My little sisters have been Thomas.
And what do you know about him anyway, except that he is the Rabbi's son? Would you be interested in him if he were the tinsmith's son or the shoemaker's son?
At least I know this. He does not have any strange ideas about turning the world upside down.
Oh, certainly. Any new ideas would be strange to you. Remember, the Lord said, let there be light.
Yes, but he was not talking to you personally.
You have spirit. And a little intelligence, perhaps.
Thank you.
But what good is your brain? Without curiosity, it is a rusty tool. Good day, Harold.
We have an old custom here. A boy acts respectfully to a girl. But of course, that would be too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Our traditions. Nothing must change. Everything is perfect exactly the way it is.
We like our ways.
Our ways are changing all over but here. Here men and women must keep apart. Men study, women in the kitchen.
Boys and girls must not touch, should not even look at each other.
I am looking at you.
Oh, you are brave. You know that in the city, boys and girls can be affectionate without the permission of a matchmaker? They hold hands together, they even dance together, new dances like this. If you like it, I learned it in Kiev.
It's very nice.
There, we just changed an old custom.
Yes, well, you're welcome. I mean, thank you. I mean, good day.
Good day.
Bielka's Prinzen, what's your name?
Hello, Papa.
Where's Zeitl?
She's in the bar.
Call her out. Repertik, how did the lesson go today?
I think we made a good beginning.
Ah, you're finally up. What happened last night besides you drinking like a peasant? Did you see Laser Wolf? What did he say? What did you say? Do you have mood?
Patience, woman, patience. As the good book says, good news will stay and bad news will refuse to leave. And there's another thing.
Oh, you die from such a man.
Oh, Zeitl, my love, come here. Zeitl, you are to be congratulated. You're going to be married.
Married?
What do you mean, Papa?
Laser Wolf has asked for your hand.
Oh, I knew it. I knew it. Oh, dear God. Today told me this was our lucky day. I thank thee, Lord. I thank thee.
You, Zeitl, what do you say?
Oh, what can't you say? My firstborn of bride. May you grow old with him in fortune and honor. Not like Frumisara, that first wife of his. She was a bitter woman. May she rest in peace. Not like my Zeitl. Oh, now I must thank Yenta. Oh, my Zeitl of bride.
Mazel tov, Zeitl. Mazel
tov. You call that a mazel tov? And you, Repertik, aren't you going to congratulate her?
Congratulations, Seidel. We're getting a rich man.
Again with a rich? What's wrong with being rich?
It's no reason to marry. Money's the world's curse.
May the Lord smite me with it! May I never recover! Knows I mean only her welfare. Am I right, Seidel? There, you see?
I see. I see very well.
Well, Zeitl, why are you so silent? Aren't you happy with this blessing?
Oh, Papa! Papa?
What is it? Tell me.
Papa, I don't want to marry him. I can't marry him. I can't.
What do you mean you can't? If I say you will, you will.
Papa, if it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll hire myself out as a servant. I'll dig ditches, I'll haul rocks, only don't make me marry him, Baba, please!
What's wrong with Laser? He likes you.
Baba, I will be unhappy with him. All my life I'll be unhappy. I'll dig ditches, I'll haul rocks, don't make me marry him!
But we had an agreement. And with us, an agreement is an agreement.
Is that more important than I am, Papa? Papa, don't force me. Please.
All right. I won't force you.
Oh, thank you.
Seems it was not ordained that you should have all the comforts in life, or that we should have a little joy in our old age after all our hard work.
Don't tell you, may I speak to you?
Later, Malta, later.
But I'd like to speak to you.
Not now, Malta, I have problems.
That's what I'd like to speak to you about. I think I can help.
Certainly. Like a bandage can help a corpse. Goodbye, Malta, goodbye.
At least listen to him, Papa.
That's right. You have a tongue, Paul.
I hear you're arranging a match for Zeitl.
He also has ears.
I have a match for Zeitl.
What kind of match?
A perfect fit.
A perfect fit?
Like a glove.
Like a glove.
This match was made exactly to measure.
To measure perfect fit? Stop talking like a tailor and tell me what it is!
Please don't shatter the rest of you.
All right.
Won't shatter.
himself? Whether you're completely out of your mind or you're crazy. You must be crazy. Oh, what, you're arranging a match for yourself? But what are you, the bridegroom, the matchmaker, the guests all rolled into one? I suppose you'll even perform the ceremony. You must be crazy.
Please don't shut me, Rotevian. As for being my own matchmaker, I know it's a little unusual.
A little unusual? It's crazy.
Times are changing, Rotevian. The thing is, your daughter Tidal and I gave each other our pledge over a year ago that we would marry.
You gave each other your pledge?
Yes, Papa. We gave each other a pledge.
They gave each other a pledge. Unheard of. Absurd. They gave each other a pledge. Unthinkable. Where do you think you are? In Moscow? In Paris? Where do they think they are? America? What do you think you're doing? You stitcher! You are nothing! Where do you think you are, King Solomon? This isn't the way it's done. Not here. Not now. Some things I will not, I cannot allow. Tradition! Marriages must be arranged by the Papa! This must never be changed! One little time I pull out the prop, and where does it stop? Where does it stop? Where does it stop? Do I have anything to say about my daughter, or don't I anyone have to ask a father anymore?
I've wanted to ask you for some time, Rotevian. But first I wanted to save up for my own sewing machine.
Oh, stop talking nonsense. You're just a poor tailor.
That's true, Rotevian. But even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. I promise you, Rotevian, your daughter will not starve.
Starting to talk like a man. On the other hand, what kind of match would that be with a poor tailor? On the other hand, he's an honest, hard worker. On the other hand, he has absolutely nothing. On the other hand, things could never get any worse for him. They could only get better. They gave each other a pledge. Unheard of. Absurd. They gave each other a pledge. Unthinkable. But look at my daughter's face. She loves him. She wants him. Look at my daughter's eyes. So hopeful. Tradition! Eh? Well, children, when shall we make the wedding?
Oh, thank you, Papa!
I promise you, Rotevian, you won't be sorry.
Won't be sorry? I'm sorry already.
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Papa. They pledge their throne. Modern children. Golda. What will I tell Golda? What am I going to do about Golda? Help!
It's a miracle. It's a miracle. And Pharaoh's heart. That was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is that out of a worthless lump of clay, God has made a man today. Wonder of wonders, miracle.
Like come from beyond the grave. Is the witch you see a dawn in the corn fight?
Yiddish, I know. Mazel tov.
Yisrael, you have a wedding hat for me.
Laser was ordered a hat, but it's not cheap.
Well, he got his bride, I can get his hat.
Then come on, I'll show you.
Can you wash the shop for a few minutes?
Of course.
Mazel tov, Father. We just heard about your sister.
Thank you.
Mazel tov, Papa. Thank you, Yenta.
Mazel tov, Hava, mazel tov.
Please, Marissa.
Why, I'm just congratulating you. Mazel tov, Hava,
mazel tov. Oh, stop it.
What's wrong with you?
Just stop it.
Now listen here, Fiedka.
Goodbye, Sasha. I said goodbye. I'm sorry about that. He means no harm.
Doesn't he? Is there something you want?
Yes, I would like to talk to you.
I'd rather not.
I have often noticed you at bookstores. Not many girls in this village like to read. Would you like to borrow this book? It's very good.
No, thank you.
Why? Because I'm Jewish? Do you feel about me in the same way he feels about you? I didn't think you would.
What do you know about me?
Let me tell you about myself. I'm a pleasant fellow, charming, honest, ambitious, quite bright, and very modest.
I don't think we should be talking this way.
I often do things I shouldn't. Go ahead, take the book. If I am a kind, happens to be Jewish, I believe.
That doesn't matter.
You're quite right. Good. After you return it, we can talk about it for a while. We can talk about life, how we feel about things. It can turn out quite good.
Oh, hello. Is there something I can do for you?
Oh, no, thank you.
Oh, wow. That's your book.
No. It's mine.
Good day, Hava.
Good day.
Yes.
Good day, Pietra.
Sweet, sweet, like a year. wisdom can I give them? How can I help to ease their way?
Candlesticks.
Oh.
Now let us not in our
joy tonight, forget those who are no longer with us. Our dear departed, who lived in pain, and poverty, and hardship, and who died in pain, and poverty, and hardship. But enough tears. Let us be merry and content, like our good friend Lady Wolf, who has everything in the world, except the bride. Laser has no ill feelings. As a matter of fact, he has a gift for the newlyweds that he would like to announce himself. Come, Laser Wolf.
Well, as he said, I have no ill feelings. What's that? He's done. I'm giving the newlyweds 5 chickens. One for each of the first 5 Sabbaths of their wedded life.
Laser, you're a decent man. In the name of my daughter and a new husband, I accept your gift. There's a famous saying that goes that when two
Tavia,
people...
Tavia, I'm not marrying your daughter. I don't have to listen to your saying.
You will listen a moment. I was going to say...
You know, why should I listen to you? A man who breaks an agreement?
Come on now, Lasers. In the middle of a wedding.
I have a right to speak.
What right? This is not your wedding.
It should have been.
Don't you attend his daughter's wedding?
But he shamed me in front of the whole village.
Quiet! Rabbi, say something.
I say, let's sit down.
We all heard the wise words of the rabbi.
Now I'd like to sing a song.
You can keep your diseased chickens.
I'll leave my chickens out of this. We made an agreement.
The terms weren't settled.
Yeah, we drank on it.
I saw them. They drank on it.
But the terms weren't settled. What's but done is done.
Once a butcher, always a butcher.
I had a sign. My own grandmother came to us from the grave.
What sign? What grandmother? My grandfather came to me in a dream and said her grandmother was a big liar!
Quiet! They drank on it, an agreement, a sign. It's all nonsense. Fiddler wanted to marry Mottel, not Laser.
A young girl decides for herself?
Why not? Yes. They love each other.
Love.
Terrible.
He's a radical.
What happens to the matchmaker? That's what I want to know.
I say. I know. Let's sit down.
Now what? Musicians, play. I dance.
Stop him!
Who will dance with me?
That's a sin.
It's no sin to dance at a wedding.
But with a girl?
You see, that's what happens when you bring a madman into your house.
He's not a madman. His ideals are a little crazy, but
it's a sin.
It's no sin. Ask the rabbi. Ask him.
Well, rabbi?
Dancing is not exactly forbidden.
There, you see, it's not forbidden.
And it's no sin. Now, will somebody dance with me?
Huddle? It's only a dance, Mama.
Play!
Well, look! Look at Tavia's daughter!
She's dancing with a man!
I can see she's dancing with a man! And I'm going to dance with my wife!
Thank you.
I see we've come at a bad time, Tevye. I'm sorry, but the orders are for tonight, for the whole village. Play! Play! All right, men! I'm genuinely sorry, Terry. You understand.
Of course.
Come, men!
Take him in the house.
Well, what's everyone standing around for? Clean up.
Tomorrow morning.
So you told me. Then goodbye.
Great changes are about to take place in this country. Tremendous changes, but they can't happen by themselves.
So naturally.
Not only me, many people. Jews, Gentiles, many people hate what's going on. Don't you understand?
I understand, of course. You want to leave. Then goodbye.
Paul, your father, the others here think that what happened at Seidel's wedding was a little cloudburst. And it's over, and everything will now be peaceful again. It won't. Horrible things are happening all over the land. Pogroms, violence, whole villages are being emptied of their people. It's reaching everywhere, and it will reach here. Do you understand?
Yes. I suppose I do.
I've work to do. The greatest work a man can do.
Then goodbye, Fletcher.
But before I go, there is a certain question I wish to discuss with you.
Yes?
A political question.
What is it?
The question of marriage.
This is a political question?
In a theoretical sense, yes it is. The relationship between a man and a woman known as marriage is based on a common attitude, a philosophy towards society.
And affection.
And affection. This relationship has positive social values. It reflects a unity and solidarity.
And affection.
Yes. And personally, I'm in favor of it. Do you understand?
Yes. I think you are asking me to marry you.
Favorite up the sense?
I was hoping you were.
Then I take it you agree, and we can consider ourselves to be engaged even though I'm going away? Oh, I'm very happy about that.
I used to tell myself that I had everything, but that was only half true. I had an aim in life, and that was everything, and now I even have you. I have something that I would die for, someone that I can live for too. Yes, now I have everything, not only everything, I have a little bit more. Besides having everything, I know what everything's for. I used to wonder, could there be a wife who shares such a difficult, wandering kind of life? Who knows tomorrow where our home will be? Everything was right at hand, simple.
Yes, they did.
two have the same matchmaker. They're going over my head. Unheard of, absurd. For this they want to be blessed. Unthinkable. I'll lock her up in a room. I couldn't. I should. But look in my daughter's eyes. She loves him. Tradition! Very well, children. I have decided to give you my blessing and my permission.
Oh, thank you, Papa. You don't know how happy that makes me.
What else could I do?
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. Thank you, Papa. What am I going to tell your mother? Another dream?
Well, perhaps you could tell her something, that I'm going away to visit a rich uncle. Something like that.
Please, Petrichek, I can handle my own wife. Golda! Golda! Hello, Golda. I've just been talking to Petrichek and Holt.
Well?
Well, they seem to be very fond of each other.
Well?
Well, I have decided to give them my permission to become engaged. I have to go inside now.
What? Just like this, without even asking me?
Who asks you? I'm the father.
What is he? A pauper. He has nothing. Absolutely nothing.
I wouldn't say that exactly.
Here he is, a rich uncle. A very rich uncle. He's a good man, Golda. I like him. He's a little crazy, but I like him. It's more important, Holda likes him. Holda loves him. So what can we do? It's a new world, Golda. A new world.
Love. Do you love me?
Why, what?
Do you love me?
Do I love you? With our daughters getting married and the trouble in this world, you're upset, you're worn out, go inside, go lie down. Maybe it's indigestion.
I'm asking you a question. Do you love me?
You're a fool.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love you?
Well?
For 25 years I've washed your clothes, cooked your meals, cleaned your house, given you children and milked the cow. After 25 years, why talk about love right now?
The first time I met you, on our wedding day, I was scared.
I was shy.
I was nervous.
So was I.
But my father and my mother said we'd learn to love each other. So now I'm asking Holt, do you love me?
I'm your wife.
I know, but do you love me?
Do I love me?
Well,
for 25 years I've lived with him, fought with him, starved with him. 25 years my bed is his.
Shh.
If that's not love, what is?
Then you love me.
I suppose I do.
And I suppose I love you.
Doesn't change a thing, but
even so, after 25 years, it's nice to know.
Thank you.
I saw. I saw your sister Hava with that Fiedka, and it's not the first time I've seen them together.
You saw Hava with Fiedka?
What did I make it up? Oh, and I saw the postman today. He said there was a letter for your sister Huddle. It's from her intended purchase.
Wonderful, I'll go get it.
I could.
Huddle will be so happy. She's been waiting for so long. But it's open.
Yeah, it happened to be open. Rika, I've got news for you. Remember, Perchik, that crazy story? Remember at the wedding when Zyko married Mother and Perchik started dancing with Tevye's daughter, Hava? Well, I just heard that Perchik's been arrested in Kiev.
No. No.
Yes.
Content to be as I was.
my child will there be to perform a marriage there in the wilderness?
Papa, I promise you, we will be married in Jordan.
No doubt a rabbi or two was also arrested. Well, give him my regards, this Moses of yours. I always thought he was a good man. Tell him I rely on his honor to treat my daughter well. Tell him that.
God alone knows when we shall see each other again.
And we will have to leave it in his hands.
Yet he is a man.
Who says that he isn't? It's just that he's a different kind of man. As the good book says, each shall seek its own kind. Which translated means a bird may love a fish, but where would they build a home together? No. Some things do not change for us. Some things will never change.
We don't feel that way.
We?
Yetker and Mother. We want to be married.
Do you know what you're saying? Do you know what this means, marrying outside the faith?
Please, Father.
No, Father. I say no. Never mention him again. Never talk about him again. Never see him again.
No, Papa,
never.
Please.
Do you understand me, Father?
Yes, Papa. I understand you.
Ah, you're finally here. Let's go home. It's time for supper.
I want to see Moto's new machine.
You can see it some other time. It's late.
Quiet, woman, before I get angry. And when I get angry, even flies don't dare to fly.
You're very frightened of me. After we finish supper, I'll faint. Come
on. I'm the man of the house. I'm the head of the family. And I want to see all this new machine now!
Gentle and kind and affectionate.
What a sweet little bird you were, Hobbler. Hobbler. Can I accept them? On the other hand, can I deny my own child? On the other hand, how could I turn my back on my faith, on my people? If I try to bend that far, I will break. And on the other hand, no. No. There is no other hand. No, Hava. No.
Please, Papa.
No.
Papa.
No. No.
Papa, come back.
How did I come to deserve such an honor?
Not just you, but all of you. At first I thought you might be spared Tevye, because of your daughter, Kaba, who married you.
My daughter is dead.
I understand. At any rate, it affects all of you. You all have to go.
No, but this little corner of the world has always been our home. Why should we leave?
I don't know why. There's trouble in the world. Troublemakers.
Like us.
You aren't the only ones. Your people have to leave all the villages. Salon, Braboleska, the whole district must be empty. I have an order here. And it says you must sell your homes and be out of here in 3 days.
And you have known us all your life. You'd carry out this order?
It's out of my hands, don't you understand? I'm not.
We understand.
You will be forced out.
We will stand
up. Fight!
Not against our army, I wouldn't advise it.
Well, I have some advice for you. Get off my land. This is still my house, my land. Get off my land.
You have 3 days.
What? After a lifetime, piece of paper and get thee out.
We should get together with the people of Zolodin. Maybe they have a plan.
We should defend ourselves. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth.
Very good. That way the whole world will be blind and toothless.
Rabbi, we've been waiting for the Messiah all our lives. Would it now be the time for the coming?
My son, we'll have to wait for him someplace else. Meanwhile, let's start packing. 3 days.
I have over 100 bottles of vodka. What will I do with them?
Where can I go with a wife, her parents, and 3 children? Well, Anatevka hasn't exactly been the Garden of Eden.
That's true.
After all, what have we got here?
A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
A pot.
A pan. A broom.
A hat.
Someone should have set a match to this place years ago.
A bench.
A tree.
So what's a stove?
Or a house.
People who pass by, Tevye. Don't even know they've been here.
A stick of wood.
A piece of cloth.
What do we need? Nothing much. Only Anatevka.
So we live in America.
Oh, cool.
He doesn't know it yet.
I wish you and the baby were coming with us.
We'll be staying in Warsaw until we save enough money, and then we'll join you.
Mother, be very careful. My mother and father, may they rest in peace, gave those to us on our wedding day.
Come inside with me, children, and help me finish packing.
Golda, I had to see you. I have such news for you. You remember yesterday I told you I didn't know where to go, what to do with these old bones. Now I know.
You want to hear?
I'll tell you. Golda, all my life I've wanted to go to one place, and now I'll walk, I'll crawl, I'll get there. Guess where? You'll never guess. In my sleep. My arrow, he came to me and he said, go to the Holy Land. So, I'm going to the Holy Land.
Oh, you're going to the Holy Land?
Yes. And do you know what I'll do when I get there? I'm a matchmaker. No, I will arrange marriages, yes. I will help our people increase and multiply. It's my mission. So, goodbye, Golda.
Goodbye, Yanko. Be well and born peace.
Maybe next time we'll meet under happier occasions. Meanwhile, we suffer, we suffer, we suffer in silence.
We'll have to hurry, Golda. Come, Golda, we have to leave soon.
Leave. Sounds so easy.
We'll all be together soon. Typo Motel and the baby, they'll come too, you'll see. That Motel is a person.
And Huddle and Horchek, when will we see them?
Do they come visiting us from Siberia every Sabbath? You know what she writes. He sits in prison, she works. Soon he'll be set free, and together they'll turn the world upside down. She couldn't be happier. And the other children will be with us.
Not all.
All. Come, Golda, we need to get finished.
I have to sweep the floor.
Sweep the floor?
I don't want to leave a dirty house.
Well, Tevye, I'm on my way.
Where are you going?
To Chicago in America.
Yeah, we're going to New York in America. We'll be neighbors.
My wife, may she rest in peace, has a brother who lives there.
That's nice.
Yeah, I hate him. But a relative is a relative. Goodbye, Teddy.
Goodbye, my friend. They're almost finished inside, sir.
Almost, Robert. Hava! Hava will see you.
We want him to. We came to say goodbye.
You're a mock person.
But at least you were here. I'll go inside with your mom. I wish you.
Hava!
Going to Krakow.
We are off to leave. We can't stay among people that can do such things to others.
We wanted you to know that. Goodbye, Papa. Mama.
Some people are driven by way by edicts, others by silence. Come, Hava.
Goodbye, Hava. Yeah.
God be with you.
God be with you.
We'll write you in America if you like.
We will be staying with Uncle Lebron.
Yes, Mama.
We'll be staying with Uncle Lebron. We'll be staying with Uncle Lebron. The whole world has to know our business.
Stop yelling and finish packing. We have a train.
Golda, I don't need your advice. Title, don't forget the baby. We're going on a train and a boat.
and his friends and put the bundles on the wagon.
Thank you. Thank you.